We tend to look at the reward system of the brain across multiple conditions and addictions and try to figure out whether someone who has an alcohol problem or an eating problem, from the brain's perspective or thinking, self-control, it actually looks very similar to gambling. Or some people with gambling might look very similar to people with obsessive compulsive disorder. And if we can figure those things out, those similarities and differences, then we can regroup people and then stratify specific treatments to that particular problem. Some people think that they're insensitive to punishment, so losses don't really register to the reward system, they're insensitive to punishment. Other people think there's a problem of probabilities and estimation of how likely they are to win based on randomness and probabilities. And there's those kind of things going on, and it seems like also in the reward system that maybe that there's a little bit of a lower set threshold of a chemical called dopamine, potentially, where the more dopamine there is, the more kind of the more pleasurable feelings we tend to get. And if those levels are low, people gamble to kind of normalize it. On the other hand, there's the properties of the machine. So the machines are designed in a very specific way to maximize habit and addiction and so that you, that kind of reinforcing. So even when you lose, it looks like a win. And to the brain, something that even though you're lost, if you receive something that looks like a win, it gets reinforced. And some of us are more likely to be seduced by that than others. When counselors say a lot of things about their experiences of when they interview clients and what's going on, we can pretty much straight away say, well, that's really interesting because we think this is how that works. And then they get excited because now there's a kind of a biological explanation for something they always knew was happening. And so they feel like they're more informed about what's actually going on, and then they can, it gives them confidence to kind of work with that concept a bit more. On the other hand, the more we learn, the more we think that, you know, people with gambling problems are not the same. We really want to come up with new ways of treating problems that are redefined from a neuroscience perspective. So for some people, we know that they're very much reward seeking. For other people, they're punishment insensitive. We know that, but we can test that from the brain perspective. Sometimes people don't know, people might not actually have the insight to say, this is why I'm doing it, but the brain might be able to tell us what they're really responding to in a gambling environment, and then we can work specifically with those elements.